Also, I think the air conditioning is like, don't smell it.
Okay, you're gonna introduce today as our first mukbang.
Hi guys, and welcome to our first mukbang.
We are so excited to be here today to eat for your viewing, entertainment, and pleasure.
Enjoy us having a random dinner, but delicious dinner, because it is economically friendly.
And I hope you enjoy our very casual conversations.
I'm having the Samuel Adams Jack O Pumpkin Ale from Costco. It's really good.
And I'm having Japan's number one beer called Asahi. And on here it says it's super dry. But I like to drink my beer with ice because it keeps my beer cold, ice cold. To our first mukbang.
Cheers.
Cheers.
So this is round two of boiling crab. And with the leftovers, we are reusing it again and having our own seafood catch of the day. I'm just having white rice. And this is also from Costco. We just heat it up for 90 minutes and it's nice and hot.
90 seconds.
90 seconds. Don't you have the Oh, it went all the way over there. Oh, and also you can see our makeshift placemat. Mm-hmm. Table cover. So what I like to do is I like to get some of the sauce and then put it in some rice like so. You can eat it just like this or with the extra pound of sausage you got from your boiling crab order, you can mix it in and that's the most delicious part. I feel like day two of boiling crab is much more satisfying than day one, for me.
And what I like to do is crack all the crabs for Honey Bun so she could eat it and not have to wait for any crabs to be cracked. And then see, I had this giant claw and then Costco, and you see that? That's like $10 right there.
Mm-hmm.
There you
Thank
go.
You. You can try it first.
Ting ting. That's all yours.
Oh, you can have. Oh, and we also told them about your special sauce.
It's lime, salt, pepper, and a little bit of sugar. And it's delicious.
And what I like to do is I like to dunk it in the sauce. And then you want to get good chunks of garlic on it. And then get a good dab of that lemon pepper sauce. And then, you don't want to touch?
No.
Okay.
Good?
Mm-hmm. Mmm. Honey, it's so good. You should try it. I'll make it for you. So again, dunk, get all that nice chunky goodness from the sauce. Don't be shy, be generous with yourself. And then get a good swig of that lime sauce. And then very good idea. Okay, now my rice. Oh, so I put the sauce in here. We can add a little bit more because it has, the rice has sucked up all the sauce. And then you put the sausage, and then you can put a little bit of the lime sauce in there. Here, babe, you can try this one. The rice is very hot. I should get a bigger spoon. I need like a wee spoon.
Crawfish spoon?
Need to get that Korean spoon. Very good for rice dishes and soups, I would say. Okay. But I am forewarning you, your stomach will hurt tonight and tomorrow. On tomorrow night. Mm.
It's worth it though.
Mm-hmm. He's a professional shell opener, crab cracker. Good, huh?
My crab got cold.
Too bad. You want to reheat it?
Some of it, yeah. Piece by piece. So good.
Oh, next time we should get our own potatoes too.
Yes.
I think you can definitely have like 3 or 4 meals out of one order.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
We should also try making a pasta out of this sauce. Like, cook pasta with the sauce. Yeah, it's like Cajun noodles.
Just like in Korea.
That
was good.
Ooh, it's spicier than yesterday.
Yeah. Mm. The spices had more time to marinate.
Oh, you know what? Did you throw away the bibs? They probably gave us extra bibs because they thought that this meal was for multiple people. And yet it's just for me and hubby.
Yes.
You can eat it as a rice dish. You can incorporate noodles in it. You can incorporate different types of meat, I suppose. Like chicken? No.
No, I think this is just for seafood.
You definitely can get your money's worth if you eat it like us. Because this was about $100,
mm-hmm.
90 something, $90 and change. And if you divide that by like four, that's $25 per person. And you always have to suck the head. That's what I meant by economically friendly. Or we should call it Woolly Crab Pack. It's pretty spicy though.
Bless you. More coming.
You don't want it because it's cool. So when Disneyland reopens, are they still not going to allow new members? New pass holders?
I don't think anybody would want to get a pass right now. Nobody's lining up to buy because their opening is uncertain if they're going to close again for a second wave.
It doesn't make sense for anybody to try to get a new pass. I think everybody's trying to get their
money back
for this year.
But I doubt they're gonna refund. I bet you they'll just extend it. I don't know, how would that work?
But, I mean, even if you go to Disneyland right now, they don't have, like, all the shows. I think they have, like, social distancing parades. All the food vendors probably aren't out. Mm. So it's kind of like, I think they all close early every night, too. They definitely don't do their fireworks display.
Nope.
Too little people to watch it. Because it's like, too little people to watch it, and then, you know, every single fireworks display.
Well, if you're gonna open, you might as well do your fireworks, because even though it's expensive, people are going for that. Yeah. Honestly, if we had kids and then we went, there was no fireworks.
Not worth going.
Huh?
Not worth going.
Yeah. No, it would be like so disappointing.
Oh, you should get that on Instagram.
What?
You should have got that on Instagram.
I'm done with the air out. I'm gonna blow right now, okay? One, two, go.
Okay, let me do this. This side looks better.
Not close. Wow, that looks so gross. Are you serious? You want that? Okay. That's so weird.
There you go. That's your piece. This is a nice, fatty piece of Alaska. So we'll start our diet again on Monday. What do you think?
What kind of diet? No, I don't want to talk about diet right now. I'm enjoying my food.
Whatever you feel like, diet. You want to feel healthy? You want to feel unhealthy?
These guys are huge. They're from Ireland?
He just said Europe.
Europe. These are European crawfish. have live crabs back there. Oh, making a little dizzy.
Is you getting buzzed?
No. It takes me more than one beer to get buzzed. I already have like three. Okay. He needs this because look, already.
So what happens when you're a person peeling all the crap? What if this whole time I wasn't even recording? I didn't even check.
Then at least we can finally eat in each other's presence. Because we're always out of our...
You mean without entertainment?
We're out of each other's presence. We're in the TV's presence.
We are controlled by the TV. These girls are all knocked out right now.
Maybe they had too much fun watching Lion King. Look at Cherry. Look at how big his stomach is. This one's probably too weak to even beg for food right now. This is actually very filling.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like that. But it is.
I think on a typical meal, you consume about 2 pounds.
At this point, I feel like 5.
Yeah.
Oh! This is a potato.
Mm-hmm. Nice. What does mukbang mean?
The way it translates is eating room.
So,
mukta is like let's eat. So muk, and then pang is a room. So mukbang. Don't ask me what ASMR means. I don't know.
Audio
something
something.
I don't enjoy it.
But you watch all of it?
No, I don't.
You do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
You do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
No,
you did ASMR of the ocean, too. You left it on, like, all night.
ASMR of the ocean.
Mm-hmm. I did. I like mukbang, I don't like ASMR. I hate people chewing out loud. How, why would I want to watch them eat? That would be like a really bad punishment.
You created a home.
You have created.
Love the home. Oh shit.
You look like you're having
ready for mom? Oh yeah, I need to eat this. I always keep the one corn I get for the very end. Did you know that corn was a gift from the Indians to the English people?
Is that what we call them? Mm-hmm.
Native Americans.
Is that the truth, or is that like a made-up U.S. history fact?
Corn is a special crop grown in North America. They didn't have corn in England.
Oh. The Europeans received it, mm-hmm.
And in return, the English took the Native Americans' land and gave them all smallpox.
Anyways, I want to watch,
Oh, did you want some corn?
Actually...
just one bite.
No, I don't like corn. I still want to watch that one movie.
Oh, sure. I better turn off the thing. See, and the trick is, if you save the rest of this...
Oh, you can make a fried rice with that. Shrimp fried rice. That would be good! What's that? That would be delicious.
Oh, we can talk about the new show that we watched, Emily in Paris. 10 episodes on Netflix, each episode 30 minutes long. We finished it straight in 5 hours. We started watching it at 9 a.m. today, and we finished 5 hours after that, around 2 p.m. Netflix asked us 2 times or 3 times, are you still watching? Yes, we are losers. We have nothing to do on a Saturday morning.
I was being productive. I don't know about you.
I'm a loser, like I said.
Don't call me a loser.
Well, actually, I was babysitting.
We had to.
I was babysitting the baby.
There was really nothing we could do. Anyways, to our family that's watching this.
Hi, Ma.
We missed you. What did you guys have for dinner?
And you're supposed to say comment in the section down below.
Well, maybe I need it up there too. Please comment down below and let us know what you have for dinner. Or what you're having for dinner right now.
So yeah, I would give you some of the shrimp, but it's like all the shrimp are kind of just too overcooked, so they're not like...
Oh, no, good. I'm good. I'm very good. I can't believe I finished that rice as well.
I think that was the first time we ever finished the crab in one sitting, because normally we had to do two sittings.
Maybe because we had less shrimp and clam. We usually have the clam left over.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what we should do? We should take that leftover sauce. And guess what I'm going to say?
I don't know.
Freeze it.
Oh my gosh, that's so Oily crab hack! So now... Oh, it's very spicy. Since basically all of this is made up of preservatives, you can freeze it.
You just gotta make sure you take off the little barnacles and heads.
Why? All the better. Mary.
Because it might get brittle and crack it and have a bunch of little...
Oh, we saved you guys from wasting our... Although it's edible.
You just want the butter, the sauce, and all the garlic.
OMG, we'll see you in a month.
So then, like next time, like let's say in 3 or 4 weeks when we want seafood again, because we don't eat seafood all the time, but when we want it again, we'll get like Dungeness crab and then we'll bust out this as a sauce. Oh, my mom's already watering.
Dungeness crab, maybe a lobster leg, shrimp, clams, maybe crawfish.
Oh, crawfish.
If we could find good chunky ones like that, that's worth it. Sausage. And lots of potatoes and corn. I would include a vegetable, but this is just not a meal where you like, put vegetables.
You're talking about you have potatoes and corn.
And corn. No, but I'm saying like greens. Eat at your own risk. It's good while you're eating it, and then all of a sudden you get really tired. And I would say 10 out of 10 would recommend this pumpkin ale. It's good.
It's made by Samuel Adams. Go ahead and please send us some more samples of any other beer you want us to try out, Sam Adams. Thank you, sir. Completes the meal.
So tune in tomorrow or whenever we feel like filming.
Ah, fudge. Peach is gonna have a fun time licking that off my watch.
I need a nap. It's early enough for me to take a nap. It's only 7.
I didn't move my car.
Yeah. Okay, good night.
Good night.
Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining.
Share, like, subscribe, comment, ring the bell.